this video, we'll be setting up a Google Analytics account and start measuring your website. It's really easy. We go to google.com/analytics. Press enter. And here we are at the Google Marketing Platform. Click over here to get started today. Sign in with your Google account. And maybe you need to two-step verify it. After you've signed in, we're going to add in an account name. It's not the name of your website, but it's like the umbrella where all your different kind of websites, if you have those, can be put into. So I'm going to create a new account for all my personal websites. And then we scroll down to the account data sharing settings. Well, these settings are actually pretty good if you don't want to share your data, for example, with account specialist or technical support, you can disable this one. If you want to link it with Google products and services, which is most of the time very useful, you can enable this one, or you can do that per app later on in the process. If you don't know what to do over here, just keep it like this and press next. Now we're going to create our Google Analytics for property data. Now you can fill in the name of your website or your brand. My personal website. Then we're going to change the reporting time zone, as this is very important as you want to know on what time your visitors are actually converting the most, so you can change your marketing efforts towards those prime times. If you say, well, my target audience is all around the world, then just use your own time zone. So I'm going to change it to the Netherlands, and then of course change your currency to your personal currency. In our case, I'm going to use the euro. And don't worry, you can always change this later on. If you're like me and you want to see the advanced options, don't worry, there is nothing you can actually do here, because the Universal Analytics properties will stop collating data starting 1st of July 2023. Why is it even still in there? I don't know. Just hide the advanced options and press next. Then we're going to describe our business to Google. It has to do a little bit with benchmarking in the same category and the same sizes of organizations, but mostly it's just to determine if you're an interesting party to use with Google AdWords so they can sell ads to you. Hey, they have to make money some way. First, we're going to select our industry category. If you click on this one, you will see that those categories are really broad and there is no actual way to dive into it deeper. And that's fine. Just choose one that fits best to your website. In our case, let's go with a other business activity because I'm making tutorials. Now, the business size is very small. It's just me, but maybe you have a bigger business. Press on next. Here we're going to choose our business objective. Why you have to choose this? Well, Google Analytics will make some reports that you can click on and you can see all these metrics. Sometimes it's useful. For example, if you want to just generate leads on your website, you're not selling anything, just leads, tick this box. If you have sales, an e-commerce platform, use this one. If you just want to raise brand awareness to spread the word about your business, but you cannot drive online sales, you cannot generate leads. I don't know how this doesn't work with this one, but okay. Or you just want to examine user behavior, like your personal blog or anything. If you don't know exactly what you're going to do with your website, just use the baseline reports. For the example now, I'm going to use all these one and press on create. Then we need to accept the terms of service agreement. First, select your country in here, in my case, the Netherlands. Click on this one, and then we press on I accept. Before we can measure anything, we need to add the code to our website. Click on platform web and fill in over here the URL of your website, like wpressdoctor.com. Make sure to use the www. If you have it, if not, leave it empty, choose HTTPS, enter in your URL. And then for the stream name, I would suggest you use your brand name, Google Analytics 4, and then the year you've created this stream. So you can always see when you have created it. Keep the enhanced measurement turned on. And if you want to see what kind of data we are collecting, press on this one. We are collecting page views. Of course, it's always turned on. We're gonna collect scrolls, outbound clicks, site searching, form interactions, video engagement, and file downloads. Now, will all these things work automatically? Yes, they will. If you press on Show Advanced Settings, you will see that the S and the search, for example, in WordPress, are automatically measured. So we're gonna press on this cross icon because we didn't change anything and press Create Stream. If you wait a bit, then the installation instructions will come to you. Now, there are two ways to install this code on your website. You can do it manually, just copy this code, place it inside of your website. But what's also possible is to go to this button, Install with a Website Builder or CMS. I don't know why there are three times WordPress, as they say WordPress, Wix or Squarespace. I don't know why this is, but let's press on Select Your Platform. Now you can choose the CMS you're working with, for example, Monster Insights Sitekit plugin or the aWooCommerce plugin. We're going to use the Sitekit plugin in here. Click on it. The next step is to actually insert it to our WordPress website, which is also very easy to do. Log into your WordPress website. If you are still using WP Admin to log in, check out my tutorial about WordPress security because you don't want to get hacked. Then on your dashboard, we go to Plugins, Add New Plugin. In here, we're going to search for the plugin Sitekit, like this. Then we have the Sitekit by Google. Press on Install Now and press Activate. Then press on Start Setup. In here, we're going to connect Google Analytics as part of your setup. And we're going to press Sign In with Google. Choose the account we just used to create your Google Analytics property and press Select All. Scroll all the way down and press Continue. I'm already verified because I used the Google Search Console first. If you're not just verified, follow the steps on the screen and let me know in the comments if you don't know how. Press on Next. Then we need to press Allow so we can see the metrics of our website in our WordPress dashboard. Then you can see this, that we've already added the website to Search Console. Press Next. And then we're gonna press Next again. Then it's going to connect with Google Analytics. And after that, you can see that we have selected from the account My Personal Websites. We have a property My Personal Website. And the web data stream is the name we have just given. This looks excellent, all good. Just press Configure Analytics. Congratulations, you have successfully set up the Google Analytics account. Also, make sure to add your business to Google Maps following my tutorial over there. And if you have any questions or you just want to say thank you, Matt, drop them down in the comments. I'll always reply.